Hey, I'm Emma Gold, 1993, and I am the winner of the 2K Cover Athlete Challenge.
A shot of the Celtics coming down the tunnel. They're not messing around. They're ready to get to work here at home. An aerial view of downtown Boston, our location tonight, gives you a great idea of the beauty of this historic city. It's time for the NBA, live on 2K Sports. Welcome everyone to the broadcast table. Chris Webber to my right, Greg Anthony to my left. I'm Kevin Harlan and David Aldridge on our sideline. A moment here now to see the numbers for Jayson Tatum.
And you can see the surge in his level of confidence lately. Just by looking at that true shooting percentage, it's been moving straight up in the past five games. I think he's feeling it.
And David Aldridge is standing by for our pregame report. David, good evening.
Kevin, thank you. Well, one thing is certain. Anyone who looks at Draymond Green's scoring is missing his impact. Last season, Green had the most 15-plus assist games in NBA history by a non-guard. And he averaged more assists and more rebounds than he did points. And his defense, of course, remains all-NBA. Guys?
What a unique player. And defense is his calling card for sure. David, thank you. This is a primetime interconference rivalry, Greg. What do you expect we'll see here tonight?
Kevin, it could be a feeling out process early, but once the teams get going, expect this thing to get physical and contentious.
Now, Golden State's starting five. And the old core of this team out there, Curry and Clay as guards with Draymond at four. Looney out there with Wiggins. And for Boston, outside the wings are Brown and Tatum. Rob Williams is out there with Horford, and it's Smart in at the one. And it's the Warriors to start out. Here's Green. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
And for a bigger guy, Green moves well to the basket. He's going to stay in an attack mode.
It's stolen by Green. Here's Curry. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
He's so aggressive at that end of the floor. And that's a quality all great scorers have.
It's stolen by Curry. His shot is good, making him a perfect 2-for-2 from the floor.
Well, you can't take Curry lightly inside. He's not the biggest guy, but he's exceptional.
Smart passes to Horford. Back to Smart. The shot's good on the assist by Horford.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Yeah, very little resistance. I mean, you have to bring much faster help than that.
Now, here's Brown. We saw him with 19 points his last outing, and it goes down 2 points.
You know, still a raw talent, but Williams does have a reliable inside game that continues to get better.
Curry outside, drains the three-pointer. Curry's got his third basket of the night right there.
A really smart opening quarter for them at the offensive end. Moving, finding good shots. They're 4-for-5 from the field.
Knocked away and stolen by Wiggins. And Wiggins throws it down hard.
And you're not going to cheat Wiggins out of points on the break. When he makes a theft in the open court, he's in attack mode.
Nice job capturing the moments on the AT&T 5G Slam Cam. Smart with the ball, and Curry picks him up defensively. Smart misses. The Warriors have gone 5 of 6 so far from the field to start out the game. And Thompson gets it to go.
And that's another basket for them. They have really come out blazing here in the first.
Hey, Chris, Andrew Wiggins showing he is an elite shot blocker at his position.
Well, Wiggins gets a lot of blocks. He gets to layup attempts when shooters thought they were safe. I mean, not always obvious. Changes a lot of shots.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
The Celtics have gone 3-of-4 from the field to start out the game. Brown wide open. He fires. And he's good on the three ball. Brown's got five now.
Oh, you love to see Brown knock down the three ball, showing great strides and improving his range.
Curry's shot is good.
As hot as he's been this quarter, the game plan is simple, folks. Get him the ball and get out of the way.
You're smart.
Green with the block. And good anticipation by Draymond. I mean, he always gets in position for these clean swats like this one.
And that was a great replay we just saw of our Mobile One block.
And right out of the gate, trying to set the tone defensively, you gotta love that energy.
Boston with it. They trail by 9 points, and the ball travels out of bounds. That was last touch by Wiggins. Here's Smart. Looking at his point production, he averages almost 11 points a game. Bangs home the trifecta.
It's amazing. Scouts were worried that Tatum would be a streaky spot-up shooter, but you see the perfect form.
Outside Curry. Trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark. Not loose. Here's Looney. Currently averaging almost 6 points a game. It's off his leg. And the official saying it was kicked. Just under 3.5 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Green breaking loose.
And despite that miss, a strong start for them offensively.
Tatum wide open. He fires one. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Tatum's got a couple of threes now in the first for the Celtics. It's three outside. That one is good. He's only missed one shot of his six taken on the floor.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
Golden and Stephen Curry with the foul. That is his first foul of the game.
It's his first personal foul. First team foul.
So the Celtics call timeout. They're first. Just sort of looking at the standings here, Greg, midseason. Do you think the conference system still holds any relevance?
Listen, I think for travel distance, it makes sense to continue to have divisions and conferences. But in the perfect world, I think we'd love to see, hey, let's just seed them 1 through 16 and determine who's truly the best.
Smart. Outside, Horford. Ball's knocked loose. Williams against Green. Driving to the basket. Williams with the block.
The reach of Williams is outstanding. It uses it to perfection to deny shooters.
So it's the Warriors now. 6-point game. Curry gets the bucket.
Outstanding start from three-point range. Their shooters are on fire.
Boston scoring 3 of 3 from deep. 9 points run up from outside in the first.
Just a little too amped up here early. Two fouls on him already. That's going to affect his playing time.
Smart deciding where to go with it. Here's the pass to Brown. Thompson with the block.
Oh, he hasn't been much of a shot blocker in his career, but Clay denies that.
A three-pointer, Wiggins, and another three for Golden State. And a moment here to take a look at some of the hustle stats for the Warriors.
They deserve a lot of credit for the defense they've played in the paint here early. Contesting shots, blocking shots, just making life difficult on their opposing shooters in general.
And the intensity is carried over into their ability to get out in passing lanes and really be disruptive in terms of their opponent's offense.
A three-pointer is right on target.
And he's starting to show that killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend the lead.
It's Smart with the drive. Takes a shot at the elbow. He can't get that one to fall. And Golden State will go the other way with it.
And this quarter, he has clearly been off the mark.
The putback, great positioning on the putback.
Looney. Well, coaches love to see that kind of grit on the glass. Looney likes to earn his rebounds.
And so it's Smart. He'll bring up the ball for the Boston Celtics. They trail by 14. They put up a nice win against the Bucks the last time out.
It's easy to score when you're facing very little resistance. That's why their offense looks so good now.
But you also got to give credit to the offense, too. They exploited every hole they saw in the defense. Such a consistent night for him from the field. Whenever they've needed it, he's been their safety valve.
Here's Smart going inside. The Warriors pull it in. And guys, this is the first they're seeing of Boston.
And it wasn't a matchup they fared well in last year, as they just couldn't figure this team out.
Celtics trail by 14. And here we go. Thompson heading to the hoop. And Thompson throws it down.
I mean, this just speaks to the two-way game of Thompson. I mean, he's excellent at using his defense to create offense.
Boston's got a perfect 4 of 4 from beyond the arc. A lot of their points coming by way of the three in the first quarter.
Taking things into his own hands. He's been a beast this quarter.
And the Warriors decide to take their first time out here. They are coming into this having notched a win against the Knicks in their last game.
Yeah, and with most of the arena against them, they just banded together and trusted one another to make the right play.
Well, the crowd didn't seem to faze them at all. They knew what their game plan was and followed it accordingly.
Making a switch here. Schroeder's checked in. Then for the Warriors, Bialica comes in for Kevon Looney. And Poole subbed in for Stephen Curry. The three from Poole. Rebound by Williams. Celtics trail by 13. And there's the foul. It'll go on Jordan Poole. That's his first foul. Williams, he's checked in for the Celtics.
Third team foul. Now into the lineup for the Celtics, Grant Williams.
Williams against Bielitsa. Williams can't hit.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on
it. Wiggins with it. Williams picks him up. Williams with the block. Outside Williams. A shot by Williams, no good. Warriors leading by 13. There's Green with the three. Buries the long-range jumper. Green's got five.
3 points.
Yeah, they built up this lead 3 points at a time.
Oh, yeah, they certainly found something along the way. Just an onslaught. 3 point bomb.
Strong move to the 10, trying to get his guys going.
Hard not to get motivated, GA, right when your teammate makes that kind of play.
They needed that, and I loved it. He just didn't settle for the lay-in.
Defensively, they've got to pick up the intensity. Hard to win surrendering this high a field goal percentage. And free agency, unkind to Dennis Schroeder over the summer. Bet on himself to get a bigger deal in the offseason. And cap space drying up quickly, and he just lacked suitors. He eventually catches on with this team, but this wasn't the ideal scenario.
Chalk up two there.
As hot as he's been, it still has to be him who leads the charge and helps turn this game around.
He leads and finds Green. Not gonna go that time. Now Boston takes it the other way. Brown with it, now defended by Wiggins. Here's Poole, and that one is stuck right through.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Going for the juggler right off the bat. I mean, jumping out to an impressive early lead.
And the Celtics with possession here. The Warriors making the shot. And Draymond Green picks up the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Richardson, he's checked in for Williams.
Now into the lineup for the Celtics, Josh Richardson.
To Schroeder, outside Williams. The shot's good on the assist by Schroeder. Schroeder's got three assists now in this one. It's Pialica. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
And how about the fundamentals right there? I mean, Pialica is so skilled at keeping his balance in the face of adversity.
A slam dunk by Richardson.
And way to finish and cut into that lead a little bit.
Yeah, but look at the basket guy still shaking. And it's Wiggins missing.
Oh, he did everything right there except hit the shot.
Schroeder, he dents the rim with a two-handed slam.
Wow. Puts the D in a tough spot when you have a point guard who can throw it down.
He really does, GA. He really does put pressure on you.
And guys, it's clear, though, he enjoys showing off his athleticism. The D can't give him these opportunities.
And again, Boston with the triple.
Oh, what incredible precision. Brown cutting the D to pieces in his pass.
Here's Wiggins. And he banks in the lane. Wiggins has got 9 points.
Punch, counter punch. Impressive offensive production early on.
Yeah, and this is what you love to see. Both teams going at it, working to get to their spots and cashing in. That's amazing, the creativity. And you see how fluid an athlete Tatum is.
Wiggins with it, now guarded by Tatum. It's Pialica. Draws contact on the shot, and now a 3-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
That's his
wow, what a pass there. He made that a very easy basket with that setup.
And he's got his first chance at the line here. The Celtics making a switch here. Richards checked in. Then for the Warriors, Kuminga's come in for Green. Porter comes in for Wiggins. And it's Damian Lee in for Klay Thompson. Free throw good from Bielitsa.
A versatile player. Bielitsa mainly excels at spacing the floor. He's a big man with range. He'll do whatever you ask him.
Score it. His third straight basket in three tries.
And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
Well, you think defensively that you try to pack in the lane. Then that opens up some opportunities for the shooters.
And cutting into the lead with the big one-hand throwdown.
That's how you get your team back into it. And Kuminga gets it to go.
When you find yourself up double digits in the first quarter, you know you're doing something right.
Yeah, true. But now it's about sustaining their energy and maintaining the focus.
It's tipped. Oh, and here we go with Lee. Nobody back. And Lee with the stuff.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely, Greg. That makes the turnover even more painful.
He Yeah, going defense to offense in an instant. Every team now calibrated to do that.
Here's Tatum. The Warriors making the shot. Unhindered, going all the way.
And finished off by Kuminga.
And this offense is in a perfect rhythm, and you can see how they're finishing their plays.
Yeah, right now it feels like they can't miss. We'll see how long Jayson they can make this last.
And they're passing the ball very crisply here.
Lee outside. His shot is good, making him a perfect 2-for-2 from the floor.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
There's a 4-second difference from the shot clock to the game clock.
You gotta love his hustle, leaving the defense no time to react.
How about then not settling? I mean, instead of being lazy with the shot selection, they go right to the rim.
Here's Tatum. That one, no good. Ice D from Porter.
They've been beating them to a lot of those loose balls and rebounds here to start. Changing ends quickly, getting the advantage in numbers and finishing. They've been doing it all night long.
Yeah, when you're executing at this rate, you feel like no one can slow down.
And that one's good.
Schroeder. You know, some scouts thought Tatum had tunnel vision, looking only for his own shot. But he's more about team.
And so it's the Golden State Warriors feeling good about their 17-point lead heading into the break. They've been putting on a clinic in the paint. Shots are falling with regularity, and they are pounding it down low. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. And this Warriors team has an interesting mix of championship vets with hungry young players. Andrew Wiggins spoke about that great dynamic.
The best on our team love to teach. If you're a good player, they're always telling us why we did it, why you should do this, why you should do that. So it's been a lot of learning and also been very exciting for the young players.
Agreed. No doubt Wiggins has been soaking up that wisdom. Greg stepping up his game in the process.
Yeah, a big culture shift coming from Minnesota. And he's blossomed under the tutelage of these Hall of Famers.
And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And guys, we've seen the Warriors really take control here.
Well, you can see these guys are unafraid to take chances defensively.
Yeah, it's a gambling style that pays off, keeping things in disarray for that offense.
You've got Dennis Schroeder, Josh Richardson out there with Jayson Tatum. Then it's Williams. And it's Pritchard in at the point. That's the five to begin the second quarter for the Celtics. Wasted no time on that one. And the Warriors lead by 19.
And with the lead, I like the strategy here. Continue to get the ball to guys who can do something with it.
You have to go to your best scorers. I mean, it's a smart strategy, and so far, it's paying off in this game.
The tenacity on that interior, just battling, bringing that effort and will for second chance points.
All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Alder.
Thank you, Kevin. The Celtics made the Eastern Conference Finals three times over four seasons, but last season, injuries and COVID protocols knocked them down a peg. Ownership and management are patiently staying the course. And with their young star talent, this team still has room to improve from within. Guys, back to you.
Other upside in a lot of people's view remains. David, thanks.
Well, I love seeing Tatum exhibit the passion he's shown us tonight. Such a motivated performance.
They're outside, and Tatum pulls it down.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
And Bielitsa kicks to Poole, and he jams it with authority.
Now that's team basketball. Bielitsa doing a nice job getting the ball to the opponent.
Quarter number two, we're about 2 minutes in. Nobody near Schroeder. Nailed from three-point land. Schroeder's got 12 in the game.
He'll do some damage if they give him that shot. Don't give him a clean look. Get out there on him.
Lee gets the bucket.
Lee.
The real. Come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
Talk about great competition going on. That's what makes a matchup like this so much fun.
And can you always depend on him or what to lead you to the right place with that pass? Money.
Here's Porter, and finished off by Porter.
Hammering it home with ease. Once Porter takes flight, just get out the way.
Pritchard passes to Williams. And it's the Warriors on the break. Jumps up, and Kuminga throws it down.
Kevin, he is tough to stop when he gets to the rim.
Yeah, Greg, he can get up a few notches higher. And so it's Schroeder with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Boston Celtics. 19-point game. Next up for them, the Knicks coming out here to play. And that'll be the middle game of their five in their longest homestand of the year. Al Horford's checked in for Boston. Then for the Warriors, Looney's checked in for Bielitsa. And Curry subbed in for Jordan Poole. Now here's Schroeder. 12 points for him. Outside, Williams shoots the three, and it's Looney with the rebound.
And on an open look like that, he's very gifted at making the weak coverage pay. And Kevon Looney, still relatively young, but injuries have slowed down his mobility.
Porter. I mean, he moves like a 15-year veteran. He thinks and plays like a 15-year veteran. Very reliable and well-rounded.
Richardson gets a wide-open look. Connects from three-point range. 5 points in the game.
Richardson. He's developed a strength and consistency. I mean, Richardson's become a valuable 3-and-D guy.
That one falls.
And they're beginning to just flat-out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Celtics trail by 20. And he drives in, lays it up, and banks it in. Curry's got 27 points.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside.
Boston's gone 2-3 when they've stepped beyond the arc in the second quarter. Here's Pritchard, guarded by Kerr. Porter against Williams. Five on the clock, and here's Richardson outside. Warriors with the rebound. Right side, Curry. Played in with a nice touch off the glass. Curry's got 8 here in the quarter.
Oh, he's perfect from the field this quarter. He's giving them the fits out there.
Pritchard passes to Williams. And it's the Warriors on the break. Here's Looney. The lead pass was put in just the right spot. Looney's got his second basket of the night.
Ripping and running. They have a big advantage now in those transition opportunities.
Horford, good.
Well, when Horford gets the ball down low, he has tons of ways to beat you.
Now, here's Curry. He had 22 points in the win against the Knicks in New York.
It's been a clinical performance. He's played a huge role and has them in position to grab the W.
Horford's shot is good.
Look, that's a nice play. You need low post scoring to keep your offense balanced.
Curry looking it over. Puts up a three. And they recover it. Porter finds Curry. Beyond the arc. The shot misses. Well, the Celtics shooting has been just uncontainable. 72%. Horford. And finished off by Horford.
With a huge frame and outstanding wingspan, it's no surprise to see Horford throw it down.
Curry from deep three-point land. It's good from long range.
Curry.
Curry's got a pair of triples in the second now for the Warriors. Time call here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. And Greg, some star big men have complained that they get hacked all game long. But they're not getting the foul calls these guards do on the perimeter.
I have to agree, Kevin. I mean, and on a lot of those fouls, the guards get 3 free throws. So something the league might want to take a look at trying to balance things out.
changes for Boston. Robert Williams is checked in for Williams. Brown comes in for Josh Richardson. And Smart subbed in for Dennis Schroeder. Then for the Warriors, Andre Iguodala. He's checked in for Kuminga. Wiggins comes in for Porter. It's Thompson in for Lee. And it's Thompson that time on the assist by Curry. Thompson's got eight.
A stronger guy than some think. I mean, it's not enough just to bump Clay. You have to do more.
Here's Pritchard. No good there. Good D by Thompson. And so it's Iguodala. He'll bring it up for the Warriors. Diving in, and it's Iguodala with the jam.
Now flying high and throwing it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys. Now here's Smart. Brown outside. That three off the mark. Golden State's gotten half their shots from three-point range to go down to second quarter. Three of six from downtown.
And you love the veteran footwork. I mean, Iguodala off the drive.
Boston's gone 2 for 5 from three-point land since the end of the first. And up the court come the Warriors on the break. Iguodala's running. And no good. The Celtics shooting 70% from the floor. Truly incredible work from this offense tonight. And the turnover again by Boston. Here's Curry. He has 35. They double-team Curry. The jump shot from the baseline is right on target. Curry's got 37. The Celtics on offense. Driving inside. And he uses the glass on the layup. Curry's got 39.
Oh, and that's the thing about Steph. Fearless on the floor, but also plays under control.
Brown outside. Steps back and frames the jump shot. Brown's got 15.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
Here's Curry. Count that one.
And I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders.
Here's Pritchard. Outside, Smart. Launches a three. The shot that time, not on target. And it's the Warriors taking it the other way. Wiggins drives in. He gets that one. He's got 11.
And he has a knack to score on the move. Wiggins stays in control even when he's at full speed.
Williams scanning the floor. Brown against Wiggins. Just 5 to shoot. Wiggins with the block.
His length gives Wiggins an advantage on the D. He can get his hand to shots that a lot of other players would not be able to impact.
Green, he's checked in for the Warriors. Clock is at 3. And Boston has possession.
Green with the block.
Iguodala with it. Picked up by Brown. Iguodala. That's good.
He's finally coming around. Trying to make up for that goose egg he put up in the first quarter.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Pritchard passes to Williams. And the basket for the fourth time from the field. He's a healthy 4 for 6.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
On its way from Curry for 2. Wasted no time on that shot, but it's off the mark. Boston's gotten cold from deep in the second quarter. Just 2 of 6 from long range. And that's out of bounds. Boston will retain possession.
Remains Boston ball.
Jayson Tatum is checked in for Pritchard. Pools checked in for Golden State. Now a timeout called by Golden State.
And Wiggins thrive as a secondary option. Seems that is the role he's best fit for. His efficiency soared.
your Celtics answer. Celtics answer.
Here's Brown. The shot's good on the assist by Horford. 17 points for Jaylen Brown. And with Wiggins, he didn't face the same pressure, Greg. Was a huge weight off his shoulders.
And that mental aspect impacts players. Wiggins was asked to do less, and as a result, ended up doing more.
Horford gets the bucket.
That's some skill on that assist. I mean, the timing has to be perfect on a lead pass.
Poole finds Green. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Green's got seven.
This is Green at his best. He's no stranger to contact. In fact, he welcomes it.
Inside. Warriors with the rebound.
Give it up for the D. No fear. You risk getting posterized. You know what, though? But you still take
Andre
him.
And the jump shot has been a dimension of this game where they've had a clear advantage.
Down low, here's Horford. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. And an area that's often underappreciated for Horford, he's a fantastic passer.
Nothing flashy. Great vision in the post or at the top of the key. And he just keeps it moving and finds the open man.
The Celtics shoot their first free throws of the game. And he makes the first.
All Horford does is affect winning. I mean, in the locker room, practice, games, he's accountable, and he holds others to that same standard.
Bialica, he's checked in for Golden State. And that one goes in. Two from the line that time. 104 left in the first half. Fires at the elbow. And he didn't get quite enough under that one. Boston's gotten cold from deep in the second quarter. Just 2 of 6 from long range. Tatum on the wing. No good that time. Wiggins with some nice D. Here's Thompson. Horford with the rebound. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Brown fires. Good, and Smart gets the assist. Smart's got his sixth assist on the night.
And Brown is a reliable threat from mid-range. I mean, effortlessly rising up for the nice-looking J.
And here's Brown. He'll bring it up for the Celtics. Pass to Smart. Here's the three. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Here's Thompson. Here's Green. And he battles for the ball and gets the second chance bucket. Green's got 9.
A lot of bunnies come Green's way because of the way he works on the offensive glass.
It's been all about Stephen Curry for the Golden State Warriors. He's been a major threat from three-point range. Got 2 of them to fall in that quarter. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much. Steve, a good rhythm for you in the first half. What do you like most about how your team's competing?
Just like the ball movement, you know, the driving kick. Our guys have played really well together. Just trying to move the ball, get a great shot.
We'll see if you can keep the ball flying around as we continue. Thanks. Back to you guys.
All right, Dave, thank you. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow right here on 2K Sports.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Good to see you back here on our halftime show. Well, actually, we can't see you, but you can see us, but you get it. Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal. You're watching the NBA on 2K Sports. The first half was all about Stephen Curry. He had a scoring performance for the ages, putting up an enormous amount of points, 5 steals, and 2 rebounds. Taking a look at the Warriors, Kenny, what'd you think?
Well, they built this lead in large part because of the sharpshooters off the bench. The subs played a superb game. Get it? Sub, superb. Oh, I'm rolling tonight. I mean, they played like starters.
And over to Shaq now. Your take on the Celtics.
First of all, where's the intensity on D? You think when a team is punking you like this, at least trying to put a stop to it. But nope. Just keep giving up open looks, letting the lead get bigger and bigger and bigger.
And that's a wrap. With the third quarter approaching, we now send you back to Kevin and the crew.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. Curry has been sensational.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
And as they can't slow him down, you know what you do? You keep feeding them and feeding them and feeding them. This is the right game plan.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. And Golden State looking at who they've got. And the old core of this team out there, Curry and Clay, as guards with Draymond at 4. Wiggins is out there with Looney. How about that mobile one block we just saw? Amazing defensive work.
And guys, they'll think twice about attempting that shot again. That was a big-time rejection.
Here's Curry. Al Horford with the rebound. Horford's got rebound number 5 here tonight. And slam dunk by Tatum.
And going right to the rim. Love the attack mindset and the ability to finish strong.
Here's Curry. And it's sent back by Horford. Over in the corner, Brown. Good, and Smart gets the assist. Brown's got 22 points.
Coming off a big game, his confidence couldn't be higher, and coach knows it.
And that's why they're running plays for him. They're getting him the ball and letting him go work.
And it's a great move, and he catches the defense completely off guard.
You'd like to see a little more energy coming out of halftime with the defensive. Curry. He's kept the integrity of their offense tonight by moving and cutting and scoring every time they've needed him to.
And slam dunk by Smart.
The ability to play above the rim. Smart can definitely throw down.
Taken away by Williams. Now the fast break. Tatum with the ball. Brown right side. Fires from deep, and the Celtics hit again from deep.
It hasn't taken them any time to find their rhythm in the second half. 4 for 4 from the field already.
It's Thompson off the drive. Well, something, Greg, we can't take for granted. It's nice just to see Klay Thompson out on the floor.
No doubt, Kevin. You know, the NBA is just a better league with a healthy Klay Thompson. Makes this team more fun to watch. Good for humor and one incredible performance a year.
That free throw good from Thompson.
And as you get older, your role changes a little bit. Now, Klay Thompson being asked to take on more of a leadership role. And I tell you, boy, he has earned it.
You know, Greg, he's one of the longest tenured players with the same team. A funny guy, but he knows the game. Shared a locker with Wiseman when Wiseman was a rookie.
And he makes both free throws.
One thing I'll never forget about Thompson, I mean, that night he dropped 37 points in a single quarter. That shows you how explosive he can be.
Brown, and Thompson sends it back. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Thompson.
Boston ball.
On defense, the Warriors, and stolen by Wiggins. From the wing, and the Warriors miss again. And so Brown will bring it up for the Boston Celtics. A step back shot here. That one rolling around and rims out. Warriors have gone 2 of 5 shooting here in the third quarter. And out of bounds as the Celtics gain possession. Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Thank you, Kevin. Klay Thompson has lost 2 prime years to a torn ACL and then a ruptured Achilles. He says so many athletes have been through this. It's just a new set of challenges. With my style of play, I feel I can be effective till my late 30s. I plan on being the all-NBA player I was and won't settle for anything less. Guys, that will be a great comfort to his team.
Indeed, and who's going to doubt him? I love his attitude. Undaunted. David, thank you.
And the determination of Brown is phenomenal. No one is going to stop his shots from going down.
And for everything he provides on offense, Chris, Brown's defense is just as impactful.
Kevin, strong, tough, quick twitch athleticism. He plays tremendous pride.
Free throw good from Brown. Now that he's attracting so much defensive attention, Greg, Brown is routinely getting others involved.
And how about his assist numbers have skyrocketed? And it's really not surprising. His sole focus is doing what's best for the team.
Now here's Smart following the miss by Draymond Green. And here is Tatum. He's got 16. Clock at 6. Lets it go with a 3. The shot's good. Brown making the play. Brown's got assist number 5 here tonight.
Yeah, those are starting to add up, guys. Of their last 5 baskets, 3 have been triples.
Now here's Wiggins. He's got 11. Yep, that one goes in there. Celtics have gone 6 of 9 from the floor here in the second half. They've got to be happy with that. Poked loose. It's stolen by Curry. And he lays it straight in. Curry's got 45 points.
You better not lose track of Curry. I mean, you forget about him for 1 second, he'll find a way to hurt you, even on the offensive glass.
Now, here's Brown. 28 points for him. Wiggins with the block. Baseline jumper. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim. Boston's gotten the 3-ball working for them in the second half. They've hit 3 out of 3 shots from long range. And it's Brown missing. Warriors shooting with confidence. Wow, 66% from the floor. Tries from 16. Good on the jump shot. Wiggins has got 15.
And Wiggins can take the mid-range when he has to. His touch makes that an option.
Now a timeout called by Boston. And Greg, with recent legal results, more opportunities now for compensation for college athletes. Do you like it?
I do. I mean, there's enough money going around. I don't have a problem with the athletes getting a share, especially with the amount of time and effort and energy they have to commit. Let's take care of the guys. Let them enjoy the collegiate experience.
Thank you.
And some changes here for the Celtics. Williams, he's checked in for Williams. Richardson comes in for Al Horford. And Dennis Schroeder subbed in for Marcus Smart. Then for the Warriors, Kuminga's come in for Green. Porter comes in for Wiggins. And Lee's subbed in for Klay Thompson. Now here's Williams. 9 points in the game so far. And it's Brown missing. Here's Looney. And good, and it takes a nice bounce off the right iron and down. Looney's got 4 points in the quarter. For Boston, they've gotten 6 of their 12 shots to drop for him here in the second half so far. Schroeder finds Tatum. Will it go? Good for the basket, number 9. He's only missed 2 shots from the floor all night.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Yeah, and they aren't just chucking up anything. I mean, they're doing a great job of creating quality looks.
And they are earning points with the jump shot now.
Here's Schroeder following the basket by Stephen Kerr. For 3, Richardson. The shot's good on the assist by Schroeder. Richardson's got his 3rd basket of the night. Here's Lee. Rebound by Williams. Williams has got his 4th rebound in this one. And here's Tatum. He'll bring it up for the Boston Celtics. And Brown throws it down.
It's amazing. The development of Brown as a scorer, and he's an exciting two-way talent. He's showing us all that tonight.
Shots good by Lee. Lee's got 9 points. One thing we've seen from these guys is excellent passing.
No doubt about it. It's fun to watch the way they're operating as a team right now. They are all in sync.
Now, here's Brown. 30 points in the game. And Looney sends it back. Now, here's Kuminga. Guarded by Tatum. Kuminga, no good.
And, guys, not sure where his head was on that shot. Not what this offense was designed to create.
Come on, you can't be selfish. You got to be willing to make the next pass. Otherwise, you're just predictable. And you see Tatum using that insane reach on the catch. I mean, he can go get it.
The Celtics shooting almost 60% from the field here in the 3rd. They are really feeling it. Ice D from Porter.
Whoops. Got caught in between moves there on his way to the rack.
And Kuminga throws it down.
Beautiful reverse jam right there.
Use the rim to protect the ball, I think. So it's Boston now. Schroeder looking around. Tatum passes to Williams. And good that time.
Williams.
And that's now 11 points for Williams.
Wow, fired that bounce pass in there. Beautiful.
Here's Looney. That's in. That's his 5th field goal. He's shooting a hot 71%. 5 for 7. Looney's gotten 5 of his 7 shots to fall. Poked away. The dish now to Kerr. Shoots over Schroeder, and he wills that one in, sinking right through off the back iron. And now we'll get a perspective here on the hustle game, how it's been going for the Warriors.
They played a heads-up brand of basketball in this entire game. They've got the steals to prove.
And also, I've been extremely impressed with their interior D. Their rim protection has been as good as it gets.
For Boston, they have yet to miss from the free throw line. They're 3 for 3.
And you really got to give them a ton of credit for what they've done at the free throw line this season. How about 82% as a unit?
First free throw is good. Celtics making a switch here. Richards checked in. And the Warriors also making a change. One Toscano-Anderson's checked in for Looney. Now a timeout called by Golden State.
Every timeout, a chance to review the lineups, matchups, or call a play.
You know, that's what coaches are paid to do, right? I mean, curious to see what they go with here.
Schroeder hits them both. So it's the Warriors now. Here's Toscano. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. Curry's got 5 assists tonight. Celtics shooting extremely well. 62% on the night to this point. Schroeder kicks to Tatum. With the drive. The Warriors shooting well. 52% in the third. They came to play offensively in the second half. Boston shooting a stellar 60% since the halftime break. Porter against Richardson. Schroeder outside. Richardson the pass to Tatum. 5 to shoot. There's the 3. And Josh Richardson hits from deep. Richardson's got 11.
I love that service. Richardson catches and fires like this. You know he's strong.
And Greg at 6'5 and 200 pounds, not the most imposing frame for Josh Richardson, but he is a quality defender.
Well, a lot of it is between the ears. I mean, the plus wingspan helps, but it's that competitive will that enables him to hold his own. And I like that they're not settling, hitting the ball on the interior, 8 of their last 10 coming that way.
Schroeder against Curry. Pass to Porter. Terrific assist. A nice finish. Solid play all around.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Time call here. The Celtics decide to talk it over.
And something we've seen the last few years, boxing ones thrown at Curry, although they've had mixed success.
All right. Look who's coming on onto the court. Come on and get loud. Here are the Celtics dancers.
Tatum passes to Schroeder. Tatum with it. He's got 26. It's stolen by Kuminga. Over Tatum. No good on that one. And it's Boston the other way.
Well, he has to work harder to get a good high percentage look. I mean, he's been taking some bad shots out there.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot 2 free throws.
Anderson. That's his first personal foul.
The Celtics shoot their 6th and 7th free throw attempts tonight.
At the line for your Celtics, Peyton Pritchard. At the line for 2 shots.
First one falls for him. Al Horford checked in for Boston. He doesn't get the second one. The Warriors shooting has been just fantastic, around 65% tonight, getting exactly what they want when they want it. Kuminga, no good.
At 87, he's done just about everything they could have asked when it comes to free throw shooting.
Two.
That's good from Williams.
And they came out of the locker room after halftime with a much more physical approach than what we saw in that first half.
And both free throws good for Williams. We've got 1:48 left in the third quarter. Shoots from the corner. And got it! Another basket. That gives him 51.
Making it look easy.
Now Schroeder. He's got 14. To the paint. It falls for the sixth time in seven tries this contest. That's 86%.
And not being as aggressive from the three-point line anymore. They had a lot more attempts in that first half.
Now a timeout called by Golden State.
Get a free t-shirt. Let me know who wants a t-shirt.
Williams comes in for Williams, and Marcus Smart is subbed in for Pritchard. Different look here for the Warriors. Draymond Green, he's checked in for Toscano Anderson. Iguodala comes in for Kuminga. Andrew Wiggins checked in for Otto Porter Jr. And Poole subbed in for Lee. Now here's Schroeder. 16 points for him. Floats it up for Williams, and it's Williams finishing it off.
What I really love about this kid, you know, Williams is that he's physical, he's explosive, and yes, he plays above the rim. He just brings that nastiness to the game.
Jordan and Poole gets it to go.
Assisted.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Yeah, they're pouring it on right here, trying to give the opposition no light at the end of the tunnel.
So it's the Celtics now. The Warriors making the shot. Here's Williams. It's rebounded by Golden State. Wiggins has got his fifth rebound in this one. Drives to the hoop. And he gets the basket. Officials blowing the whistle, so a chance at the line for one more.
That's his first.
They are just killing him on the interior.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight.
Andrew.
And from the line, he's knocking it down about 71% of the time, and that's a percentage that needs to go up.
Free throw good, Wiggins.
And the winner's mentality Wiggins has is commendable. A hard worker who wants to keep improving.
And stolen by Wiggins. From past the arc. Good on the three-point shot. Wiggins has got 21.
Three.
That gives him 2 3-pointers for the game. One in each half. I mean, he may add to that total pretty soon.
For three, Richardson. Warriors with the rebound. Green's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Over Smart. And it's Green, missing. Richardson left side. And the last shot before the buzzer is off. And as we conclude the third quarter, pretty much a blowout. It's been a one-sided affair. Warriors ahead, finishing the quarter on a tremendous 8-0 run. We're going to step aside for just a second, but join us right back here for the start of the fourth quarter next. And a quick look now at the State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, and I like the fact we get to see this pass one more time. A magnificent feed, and you love to see your off guard taking over the playmaking duties with this much skill.
Well, I like that he didn't make his decision too early. You know, he let the play develop. That's how you do it. Finds the weakness in that defense.
And one quarter to go in a game that, to this point, has not been an evenly fought contest. That court guard set is Smart and Richardson. Then it's Ennis Cantor. Then it's Langford. And it's Hernan Gomez in at the four. That's the Boston Five.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference in points in the paint between the two teams.
Takes it inside, and Langford with the stuff.
Yeah, high IQ basketball from Richardson. Values the easy assist over a risky shot.
Here's Wiggins.
And how about getting the band back together? I mean, Iguodala in a Warriors uniform considered retirement and couldn't resist one more run with the team. He's won three titles.
Wiggins, two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Greg, player movement is always a constant in the NBA, but with more players on the move every year, the power balance can shift in the blink of an eye.
And we've seen it with the Lakers, right? Just a few years ago, the Nets and a few others. Not everyone, though, loves it, but it sure keeps things interesting.
And both free throws good for Wiggins. Boston shooting 61% from the field, showing some marvelous touch out there. They get a hand on it. And it's the Warriors on the break. From about 19 feet, rebounded by Langford. And it's Smart with the ball for Boston. Passes to Richardson. 60 seconds off the clock here in the fourth. And Wiggins throws it down.
Wiggins. And there's one thing that's never been in question about Wiggins: his ability to be a high-volume scorer. And in case you needed a reminder, he's giving you one.
And it's Richardson slamming it down.
Richardson.
Now that's how you lead your teammate into an easy scoring chance. I love that assist.
Here's Poole. And that one comes up a bit short.
They haven't needed him as much as I thought they would tonight.
To the inside. Here's Langford. Makes it off the glass. Langford's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Not lacking any confidence down there. Just give Langford the ball and let him do it. Just powered it down with both hands. You know he's not going to mess that one up.
Oh, no, not this fella. He is a superb finisher. Fourth quarter. They came out of the... Wiggins against Smart. And up the court come the Warriors on the break. Wiggins with the ball. They get it back. That's tipped.
We don't talk much about his defense. I mean, Cantor has been much maligned for his work at that end. But he's been making a better effort.
Richardson, no luck.
The D making that layup look very uncomfortable for aggressive work down low.
And the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Wiggins. Neesmith, he's checked in for Richardson. And the Warriors also making a change. Moody's checked in. We're in the fourth quarter here, just under 2.5 minutes gone. Neesmith can't get it to go. The Warriors shooting in the fourth quarter has looked shabby, 38%. With the fadeaway. No good.
And that's really just not heads-up basketball. Don't try a fadeaway when nobody's guarding you.
And it's in there.
Hernan Gomez.
Hernan Gomez has got his first points of the game.
And a sharp pass to set up that high-percentage shot in close.
Now here's Iguodala. Here's Moody. And he gets the bucket.
Moses. How frustrating Moody. For the defense. You get the stop, but then fail to block out.
Yeah, and it's inexcusable. But all too common. Basketball one-on-one. And shot goes up, put a body on someone.
And this is where Langford can really improve as a jump shooter. Off the catch, looking really good on that one.
Cool, no good.
He's done a lot of the little things to help put them in front. I mean, but his offense has not been there for the night.
To the middle. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Moody.
It goes on Moses Moody.
Personal foul.
I got to appreciate how aggressive Cantor is on offense. I mean, it's what earns him trips to the line.
Greg, last season, we saw a lot of opinions about the play-in tournament, especially from players. Where did you fall on that thinking?
Well, I'm going to put on my fan hat right now, Kevin, and I thought it was exciting. I mean, seeing the stakes get raised for those teams that are right on the edge, I think it brings more interest for teams. But if I was still playing, I probably wouldn't like it if I had locked up the playoffs and still had to go play to earn a berth.
Looney's checked in for Andrew Wiggins. And the second free throw, good.
One of my favorite trash talkers in the NBA, Cantor, never really shies away from taking jabs at opponents. And I think his teammates like that.
Poole on the wing. Guarded by Smart. And they'll get another chance. The Elites and misses. Boston's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Got a piece of it. Iguodala with the steal. Over Nesmith. It's by Elitsa, and the layup is good.
Offensive rebounding is all about positioning and hustle. I mean, there, Bielitsa showed exactly how you get these additional opportunities.
Outside, Smart. Here's Langford, and Langford with the stop.
And one step ahead of the defense with that solid screen.
And then, Greg, the monster dunk to finish it off.
Well, come on, guys. Someone has to rotate over. Defensively, that's just poor communication.
Moody's shot is off. For Boston, they've gone 6 of 8 from the field in the fourth so far. It's been a great start to this final quarter for them.
And what impressed me about Smart last year, and we're seeing it this year as well, his patience and precision as a playmaker.
And the assist totals show how far Smart has come.
Averaging around 3 dimes a year at the start of his career. He's now doubling that effort when given the minutes. Good sign for him and this team.
Two shot.
And the first one drops. And Greg, you faced some exceptional point guards during your time in the league. But who was the toughest matchup for you when you played?
Oh, man. You know, John Stockton was always one of the most difficult, but in a weird way, not because I worried about him scoring on me. It was because I had to defend his ability to make people better, and that was always a challenge. And don't forget about the great Penny Hardaway. I mean, at 6'8", that was a nightmare to deal with. And my personal all-time favorite, Isaiah Thomas,
Damian Lee, who was
as good as anybody's ever been at that lead guard position.
And it's Smart with the ball for Boston. Knocks it loose. Lee with the steal. And the pass to Iguodala. From down in the low post, it goes.
Artful movement by Iguodala to beat the defender puts him in prime shooting position.
Iguodala with the steal. One-on-one fast break. Here's Looney. And there are the Warriors now with another bucket.
He's getting hotter the deeper we get into this game. I mean, he didn't give him much of anything in the first half.
Tipped away. Lee with the steal. Over Smart. No good from Lee.
It isn't the D that causes that miss. That's just a loss of concentration at times.
Here's Looney. Chris, you made the postseason all 7 years with the Kings. Deep playoff runs, sensational play. Talk about the chemistry on those teams.
Well, chemistry was very important, Kevin. I knew that being a leader on the team, that it was incumbent upon me to make sure all players felt comfortable. Not only that you would hold them accountable, but that you would include them. You know, we were a family. Shout out to all my fellas that I played with. I wanted to make them better. I hope I did, but they all made me better.
Now a timeout called by Golden State.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and the coach sees something he doesn't like here.
Yeah, I like the chess match that's going on here. Each team trying to find and exploit the favorable matchup on the floor.
Richard's checked in. Juan Toscano-Anderson's checked in for the Warriors. Warrior shooting indicative of smooth offensive play. Up at 60%, they're a machine from the floor. It's Bialica. No good off the front iron. Boston's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Down low. Here's Langford. Pass to Hernan Gomez. Hands it from downtown.
Well, this is the kind of ball movement they want to get from here. Just stand the floor. When you spot the open man, get it to him.
Here's Iguodala. Offensive rebound. The second chance effort. That one doesn't go. Boston's gone 2-3 in the fourth quarter from long range. Good shooting so far. To the paint. Here's Hernan Gomez. And finished off by Hernan Gomez.
And you see Langford's ability as a facilitator, great court awareness.
Shot from the wing. To the wing right side. Here's Moody. And it's Bialica with the foul. That is his first foul of the game.
That's his first personal foul. Second team foul.
Celtics have gotten exactly two-thirds of their shots to find the bottom of the net here in the fourth. 8 of 12. Richard passes to Nesmith. Knocked loose. Now the Warriors moving it up for the finish. And the slam by Moody.
Moody, that's a double whammy, guys.
That's right. A great defensive play, then the emphatic stuff.
Oh, yeah, bang, bang. An impressive sequence that has them fired up.
Richard passes to Nesmith. Now Hernan Gomez. And Moody pulls it down. You sometimes hear people say games are called too closely. Are you of the mind that the refs need to let them play?
I'm understanding the mindset that the refs need to understand that we didn't come to watch them. We need to be consistent. That's all guys ever complain about. When you see a guy going up to the ref, he's usually saying, hey, you didn't call that on the other end, or you called that on the other end. So consistency. I mean, these guys are trying to do their job to the best of their ability, but they need to be more consistent.
Here's Pritchard. Pass to Nesmith. Down to five on the shot clock. Langford, the pass to Pritchard. He's covered by Bialica. Such a wide open look.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
That's a two from Lee. Misses off the left iron.
The rotation in the D could be better here. It'll cost them next time if it's not.
Took him no time at all on that one.
So many of the plays they're running designed to create opportunities from deep.
You see more teams doing this nowadays. We all are firmly entrenched in the era of the three ball.
That's a shot he's got to hit. You don't get many looks better from that range.
Pass to Toscano. Banked in off the glass.
Excellent work offensively to get that shot attempt into a can't-miss area.
The pass to Langford. Here's Pritchard, three-pointer, and again, Boston with the triple.
And all of a sudden, things finally coming together for them. The deficit still large, but now not insurmountable.
And the longer the run goes on, the more momentum will swing their way.
Good work there as it goes. Iguodala has got six here in this quarter.
Yeah, certainly not lacking any confidence. Iguodala knows he has the ability to score from anywhere.
2 minutes remaining in the game. 2 minutes.
He's covered by Bielitsa. Pass to Pritchard. We always have some tweaks to the rules every season, Chris. What do you think the league should focus on now when it comes to the next changes?
You know, I would hope the league would address the board. I hope they would address the ownership. I hope they would address management. Hopefully, the league can start to look like the makeup of the players that it employs when you talk about ownership and things of that nature.
Pass to Nesmith. They get it again. The third shot of the possession finally falls for him.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest. Just a total obliteration, if you will. And you can safely say mission accomplished now for the Warriors.
The coaching staff must be happy that they controlled their turnovers so well in this game.
Excellent self-control and patience tonight.
And so this is going to end up as victory number 24 on the year.
And so they win their first game against this squad. It's a two-game season series, and they'll be going for the sweep the next time they face off. And when you look back at this one, what an amazing performance this was.
For Stephen Curry.
Well, he was the agitator, bothering everybody with his defense, coming up with steals. I mean, making sure they were never able to get comfortable as long as he was out on the floor.
Now a timeout called by Golden State. They're in front by 21. 51 seconds left in the fourth. The New Balance player of the game, Stephen Curry.
And what an amazing ball game we've seen from him. It's been a one-man show worth the price of admission all by itself. There wasn't anything he couldn't do on that court tonight.
He silenced this crowd with an unreal display. His ability to drown out the noise and the hostility of an opposing crowd is pretty special.
And, guys, not sure where his head was on that shot. Not what this offense was designed to create.
Come on, you can't be selfish. You got to be willing to make the next pass. Otherwise, you're just predictable.
That's a two from Lee. And, again, it's the Warriors missing. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Here's Schroeder. And there are the Celtics with another basket.
It's always great to get into a rhythm, but do it when it matters.
Yeah, it has to be frustrating to catch fire when the game is already over. I mean, this is not the outcome they want.
Outside Tatum. All sorts of time, and it's Boston with another.
Wow, nice touch on the mid-range there. Tatum's a player who scores everywhere on the court.
See the Warriors taking the game here. And in the win, a comfortable win in what was, I think, a pretty hostile environment.
It really was. You know, it's never going to be easy on the road, but they didn't have too many problems with that tonight.
And we've got David Aldridge standing by on our sideline with the player of the game. David, it's all yours.
Thanks very much, Stephen. Even for you, rare form tonight. How do you do that?
A lot of work. God's blessed me with a lot of talents, and I just have a lot of confidence. My teammates have confidence in me, so for me to just continue to play hard, stretch my imagination, what I can do, and just let it flow.
There were no limits tonight, man. Thanks very much. Back to you guys.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Chris Weber, Greg Anthony, and David Alton, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.